believe a word of it. A single blinking word of it.
Whoever ever heard of it, a boy like him? If you'd like to know what I think, I'll tell you. Not half.
Well, tell us.
You're jealous.
Vardy, that's a laugh.
It ain't a funny joke at all, a funny blooming joke at all. He ain't that kind of bloke at all. Just use your eyes. It's all a pack of blinking ruddy lies.
Lies,
lies, lies.
I'd like to know just what you're driving at.
When a boy gets whiskers on his chin, he will soon start falling into sin. For he'll meet those irresistible forces, horses, women, and gin.
When he's tasted pleasure once or twice,
you'll surely have to pay the price.
Nothing underlines his character quicker than liquor. Ladies and boys.
He wouldn't do that to me. It's perfectly plain to see. Philandering ain't ever the kind of thing he'd do. He gave me half a sixpence to prove his love was true.
Half a sixpence?
I'm sure in my heart that he
I don't believe a word of it, a single blinking word of it. Whoever ever heard of it? It's not like him. Why, he couldn't be unfaithful, not ever, to me.
He's lying.
You're crying.
Well, just you wait and see.
Last night he made a night of it. He hates the whiskey quite a bit.
Whiskey? He hates the blooming sight of it. It's just absurd. I don't believe a single ruddy, rock, blooming, blinking word.
You look very...
Shut up!
Oh, listen, love, I've got a lot to tell you. There's this fella came in on a bicycle, you see, and all of a sudden...
I hope it ain't too impolite to inquire what happened to you last night. You were drunk, so Lord, and I'm going to tell you were out with a couple of girls as well.
I don't know any girls. Oh, listen, love. Ow, ow. Well, you see...
I really enjoyed the promenade while you were somewhere drinking hard and having fun with Flora.
Well, actually, her name was Laura.
Laura?
I tore my trousers. She sewed them up. Look.
Don't tell me, I don't want to know.
Well, I was only in her dressing room and she had her stays on.
It's you and her getting up to your tricks while I'm at lamppost number 6. But don't mind me. It suits me fine to hang around till half past nine.
It wasn't Auntie's fault. Sharp had made him go carving wood.
That's good. Carving wood.
Well, he had to.
Yes, and keep a lady waiting.
And
a lovely gentleman looks at me and gives me a proper thrill when he comes up to say hello.
How dare he?
Don't you start abusing her.
I'm not alone.
That's nice when
Auntie
picked up like a street girl.
Well, if I'd been there.
You wasn't so there. You were too busy dancing with all those girls.
What girls?
It was a few, actually.
Don't tell me, I don't want to know.
Well, if I'd been there, I'd have knocked him down.
Did you know I'm going to kick?
As bad as Miss Walsingham.
And who the heck's Miss Walsingham, for heaven's sake?
It's my Miss Anne.
You've got a proper harem, and no mistake.
Anne.
Mr. Casanova kick.
Who?
You eared. Gloomy.
Now, what about this man of yours on a promenade?
A little bit late to clench your fist and stand there looking grim. You wouldn't have cared if I'd gone off with him.
You should have done, Anne.
With a stranger?
Well, Aunt was having his fun all right while Anne was waiting around all
you
night.
You shouldn't go talking to men in the dark.
Don't tell me, cause I'm...
Which talk to Anne like that?
I'm talking to you!
Anne!
You men are all the same beneath the skin. You better go by wooing her and then proceed to ruin her.
I only kissed you once.
Shut up! You take a simple girl and lead her into sin.
They only want one thing.
But once you had your way with her, you wouldn't want to stay with her. It's her.